Hey guys, Richie here from RW Hobbies. Welcome back to part number three of my 32nd scale Jetmads Viggen build, all resin kit and 3D printed resin. This part, we're gonna do an exciting world of intake ducts. And basically get to this stage you see right here, we get this whole front end section done. All right, welcome back. So last time round we did the seat, looking very cool. This time we're going to work on, we skipped a few pages forward as I mentioned last part, we're not going to do the cockpit tub, we can work more on the main assembly back here, and that's the intake duct assembly. So a few things since last time, went to the hardware store, got myself some more super glue, got myself some 5-minute epoxy resin, Bob Smith's. I like this because it's separate containers, but the ones that you kind of squirt and when it goes into like one container, it kind of blocks up a little bit. Where you got separate, I think it's these a little bit easier to kind of last longer. It got hardened in a resin. And this is what we need to, you know, put this stuff together is some epoxy resin. It's got that. And also, we're going to do some hardcore sanding and filing here. I thought, you know what? I got a rotary tool, I got a prox on. So let's, rather than manually doing this, let's put some machinery on this. So I went to Home Depot and the Dremel branded stuff was really expensive. Like a little box of attachments was like $25. Now I know Amazon or AliExpress, you're probably getting really cheap, but it's just very expensive, the Dremel brand. So I think it's just paying for the name. And they actually had the Ryobi here hanging up for $10 or $10.97, I think it was. And you got all kinds of different sanding stuff and cutting stuff in here. So I think this will work perfectly. So got that because the first thing we're gonna do here, well actually I've done a couple of things already. So I've cut out the area here for the rat, ram air turbine, and this little hole here per the instructions, and simply just with a knife, just taking my knife and just scoring it several times and then just push right out, no problem at all. Same with this guy here. So cut those areas out first, and if you look down the end here, I'm not sure you can see on the camera, but it's a little gnarly. See there? It's a little bit rough, so that's why I'll take my prox on and just sand back a little bit in here and just smooth it out, because what's going to happen is these intake ducts here are going to fit down here and slide into the mark left and right. So this is the left one, this way around. So they're going to slide in a gap right here. If I get it right, I think it's this way around. Yeah. And what you're going to do is you're going to push those forward to the front, but you can see there's a little bit of gnarliness there. It needs to be sanded away so it can fit flush to the front here. And per the instructions, they make a note of this. You put the right side in first, not the left side. So, and like what I've done here, you can put the right side in. And there's a couple of grooves, but again, just need to clean it back here so it can slide all the way to the front so these things are flush. So that's the first step. So I'm going to be down dirty here. Again, resin, so I can wear my mask and be safe. Get my prox on going. I'll sand some stuff back, and then we can start to put these intakes in. Alright, so sanded down the inside, no problem at all. My prox on, nice slow speed, and I ended up using the 120 grit on here, and it seemed to do a pretty good job. Be able to control it okay, and I got rid of a little bit of the gnarliness from the casting inside and smoothed it out. So if I try and put one of these in real quick, you can now see it's flush, perfect. Without, it would push right to the end front. So you see here, also painted everything up to all the intakes, parts, usual, Mr. Surface of 1500 black primer, and then spray white over the top. I just find black below white makes it, gives that really kind of some depth. And also, you know, I don't hose the white on, I mist it on, you can see the black underneath, it gives that kind of nice kind of bit of a grime kind of effect. This is AK Extreme Metals steel, again over the black primer, no problem at all. This is one part, no cleanup required. You see quite a nice looking fan blade here. So this simply just glues on the back of this part. So take some super glue. Pretty generous. And this just fits in like that. And there you go. Easy as that. So now I'm going to go ahead and put the intake ducts in, and reminder, you do it the right side first. Again, I'm just gonna put a little bit of glue just to hold it in, super glue, right side. Then we're going to do the other side. I'm not going to glue this bit right here because I want a little bit of wiggle room, this bit, because this is going to fit over the top. I want to be able to manipulate it a mil or two just to kind of make sure it lines up. So I'm not going to glue this bit, I'm just going to glue the front. Yeah, I'm just going to push it, make sure it's flush, use my finger fully in, and on the back there you see how they kind of interlock. I'm just going to get my fingers just kind of get lined up a little. And then this is just going to sit with the 14 on the top. It's just going to sit over it. Like that. And then if you look down, not that you can see much, but there you go. That's kind of how it's going to look. So I'm going to let this dry, the glue, and I'll glue this on the back, and this completes that part of the assembly. Alright, so a couple days later, and we got this guy put together in there, and you see down the intakes, the fan blade, and a couple spaces around there, and they're pretty much just glued in, and that's so when we slot this guy together, it just kind of helps with the fit a little bit there. You see, already see, we've got a little issue with a gap and stuff, and a seam for later on to take care of. But anyway, so that, those couple bits go in there. Just use my trusty, I've had this for years now, you've seen me many times, this Gorilla Glue clear glue. It's just very, very strong. It takes a while to set and go off, but that's why I used to glue those two parts in. I think I used it for this part too, possibly. So that's in. Top tip with the rat, ram air turbine, you probably want to put that in before you put the spacers and this part in, because it's actually before you put the center part in here, because it's a little bit of a tight fit to get in there. But it slides in, no problem at all. Parts are in there, and this, it was a real nightmare to get them in. They just didn't seem to fit very good, so I had to kind of really trim them down. Got that one in. This brass piece here, I lost the piece, broke off. We'll see what I do with that, if I leave it as is, or just put a door on top and close it up, which I'll probably do. So that was a really hard fit, these two. Again, just had to trim them off. I just couldn't get the fit at all very well. So did that, then onto the intakes themselves. Now, I looked at some pictures. It's hard to tell, but I think it's aluminum. And then if you look further back, there's a distinction where it's white further down. So we obviously painted these white, but there is an area where it starts off aluminum at the front, and I think it turns to white further back. So what I simply did was, with my tweezers, I carefully kind of put some masking tape in and kind of wrapped it around. There's a line in there. It's a really nice detail inside these. You see that? So let me look, see where the... Here it is, where the tape starts. I'm just going to rip it off. And there we go. We've got that nice kind of seam line. Not seam line, but line with where the aluminum switch back goes back to the white. Now, on this one, we can see I've not done this one. So I masked it and I threw some foam back here to block it and just sprayed it. So sprayed the white first, masked it, threw the foam in, and then just sprayed the silver or the aluminium or aluminum. And then we'll take this one off too. And then there you go again. See that line? That's along the natural pound line, which is on the inside there. So there you go. I'm not one, don't quote me on this or follow me. It's really hard to tell. Some pictures look like the whole trunking was aluminum. Some look white with, like I did there, which way I did it, and I'm happy the way I did it. But I'm not a rivet counter, but it's just sometimes hard to see metal. Sometimes it looks like white when the sun shines on it. So that's where we're at. So next up really is to kind of glue these guys on. And you can see there's a bit of a fit issue again. Nothing too crazy. I did sand these down already. There's a bit of a gap, but nothing too bad. It's going to be, you know, by the time you fill it, and with a leaf camo, which is going to be very kind of busy, you're not really going to notice it. So both of these go on. Again, a little bit of sanding just to kind of clean up what I did already. And to glue those on, I'm going to go with the first time ever actually going to use epoxy. So I'm going to use this, which I showed you earlier, the Bob Smith's 5-minute, which is just a 50-50 mix, I believe. I'm not actually read the directions yet. Same size, I'm sure it's 50-50, so I'm just going to mix them up, tiny little piece, and then we'll get these glued on into place, and then I think that's enough for this part. To wrap it up, we've done a lot of progress here. Happy how it's looking. Again, the rat did turn out so good back here, but we do have a a 3D printed door we could put over it if we want to do that. All right, so got them glued on, one side at a time, did one side, let it dry, and then did the other side. No problem at all. Just held it in place those 5 minutes for it to go off, and now it's pretty solid. A little super glue and kicker just on the inside here, just to kind of get pushed in and get rid of those seam lines. So with modeling, kind of want to take care of what you see, and that's the sides. Make sure it's square on the top. On the side, you're not really going to see when it's on the desk or table. So I made sure that was my main concern was getting these lined up around the sides squared. And then underneath is where we got our seams. You see probably about 1 mil there. Actually, not 1 mil, but I don't want to push it too much, otherwise it's going to knock it out of sync here. So not a problem, because simple. I'm just let it dry for a little bit, and I'm going to run some Tamiya putty around it, some filler, take those gaps and around the edges here, and we'll sand it and take care of it, and it'll be completely seamless, no problem at all. So that kind of really kind of reinforces why I did this first without the cockpits up, because you get tons of dust and everything and mess. I don't want to get all of the switches and the seat and all the rest of the cockpit tub. That's going to be pretty kind of delicate. So I want to take care of the mass construction first, and then once that's done, we can come back and redo the cockpit tub and get the nose gear bay and stuff next week. So yeah, I'm going to wrap this video up. I'm pretty happy how it's progressing. Really enjoying this resin kit. A little bit of a challenge for me, and something a little bit different. It's been a lot of fun so far. So I'm going to off camera, I'm going to take care of those seams, and hopefully by the time you see me next video, these will be nicely sanded down and seamless. Thank you as always for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye.